This is Mission Control Houston. Welcome to today's ISS update. It is April 11th, 2012. Good Wednesday to you. You're looking at a live view of the International Space Station Flight Control Room here at the Johnson Space Center in Houston. This team here today being led by Flight Director Ron Spencer. He is there standing up. Sitting beside him is today's CAPCOM, the voice of Mission Control up to the astronauts. That is Jeremy Hansen. The Expedition 30 crew on board the orbiting complex has a pretty busy day today. They've been working on a variety of different maintenance activities and also some experiment work. Dan Burbank, second from the left there, he is the commander of Expedition 30. He's been working the majority of his morning and also this afternoon on rewiring the motor of what is called the amine swing bed. This is basically a test model for what could become the future way of scrubbing carbon dioxide from the International Space Station's atmosphere, obviously regenerating that atmosphere, and the air inside the orbiting complex is important. So experiments continue on board the complex to make those devices that scrub that air smaller, more efficient, use less power. So this amine swing bed, which you're seeing a video of here, is one of those experiments that the crew is testing out with ground teams to see if they can make it smaller, lighter, and more efficient for not only the space station itself, but also future spacecraft as well. Anton Shkaplerov has been working in the Russian segment today on what's called the typology experiment. It looks at how the crew members adapt to living and working in space. They take a look at different visual cues on a laptop computer and report what they see. This takes a look at their neurology, how their eyes are working, how their brains are working, and just measures those changes that happen to the crew members' bodies while they're up in space. He is also packing up equipment and supplies that will come home aboard the Soyuz at the end of the month, the crew getting ready to return home toward the end of April. Anatoly Ivanishin, also working in the Russian segment, taking some water samples from inside that particular portion of the International Space Station. This is done periodically just to make sure that the water that the crew uses and that they drink is acceptable and doesn't have any bacteria or anything like that growing in it. So he will take care of that this afternoon. He's also working on a cardiac experiment to measure and take a look at how the crew members' cardiac systems react to being up in space. Obviously, the human body is one of the primary investigations that take place aboard the space station, learning how our bodies react to being up in space for up to 6 months while the crews are up there. Those lessons are going to be very important as humans take a look at expanding beyond low Earth orbit, traveling to destinations such as Mars. Oleg Kononenko also finishing up some work, packing up the Progress 46 that is currently docked with the Piers docking compartment. That is one of the cargo craft that visit the International Space Station throughout the year. That particular Progress launched back in January. You see the map of the station there, the Progress 46 down toward the bottom right-hand side. It launched in January, headed up to the station, brought up a little bit less than 3 tons of food, fuel, and supplies for the crew. It's time aboard the space station coming to a close. It's going to be undocked coming up on April 19th, and it will eventually be sent into a destructive reentry in the Earth's atmosphere, packed full of trash and other items that the crew doesn't need anymore. Don Pettit and Andre Kuipers have been busy this week, including today. They kicked off earlier this week 2 weeks' worth of onboard training. All of this is leading up to the SpaceX mission, which is coming up toward the end of the month. That launch currently scheduled for April 30th at 11:22 a.m. Central Time, 12:22 p.m. Eastern Time. It'll take a couple days for the SpaceX Dragon to get up to the station and to perform these demonstration maneuvers as part of this test flight. This is a look at some of the onboard training that Pettit and Kuipers have been doing this week. Basically, they will be running some simulations inside the Destiny laboratory. There's two different robotic workstations on board the station, one in Destiny, one down in the cupola. They've been running these checkouts inside the Destiny workstation, the U.S. laboratory, basically practicing the maneuvers that they will do coming up once Dragon nears the station and performs a rendezvous. They'll be using the station's robotic arm to reach out and grab onto Dragon, which you see here. It's a little bit different than what Progress and the Japanese It's very similar to what the Japanese HTV does, but it's very different from what the Progress and also the European Space Agency's automated transfer vehicle do, which is those vehicles actually dock themselves to the International Space Station. But Dragon will do something very similar to what HTV does, which is where it will just sort of hang out and loiter away from the station a few dozen feet. And then the crew will use this robotic arm, taking a look at these laptops that you see here, to reach out and grab on to Dragon, monitoring the progress of this the entire way. In addition to all of this, the crew had some Crew Earth observation opportunities today. They will be flying over Oklahoma City and Los Angeles. They had a chance to take a look at those two cities right before sunrise. They'll also be flying over Swaziland and finally over St. Helena Island. Of course, if you would like to take a look at any of these photographs, just log on to the NASA website, www.nasa.gov/station.